Anyone else have an announcement this morning?
I do, Joe. Just the regular missions announcements. So the tree's going up in just a couple of weeks. The Giving Tree's going up. There's going to be online sign up for. We're doing, I believe, three different organizations this year. So there'll be opportunity to sign up online for like fuel assistance and clothing. There'll also be the angels will go up on the tree for gift cards and things like that. We're also still collecting tabs, both tabs for the bread and for the metal bottle, you know, bottle tabs. We are doing Life Bridge this coming up Monday. I believe Rachel is doing that. Maybe short one person if anybody is interested in doing that. And we're collecting spices and food and flour and oil. And added, you know, like some things for, you know, to make people feel comfortable in their baking and things like that for our collection for the food pantry.
Thanks, Annie. Anyone else have an announcement this morning? I don't see any. So give Annie a chance to switch screens and she will go ahead and start the prelude.
We'll definitely attempt that.
Okay, so I think we're all back now from the prelude. And the way this will work this morning is Jan is our liturgist and will read. We're asking the rest of you to stay muted, but I'll represent you out loud as the response. So let us begin with our call to worship.
Jesus is in our midst. Jesus, our healer, deliverer, and friend is here.
We have heard so many good things about him, but we long to meet him, to encounter him ourselves.
Call out to him and do not be silent. like Bartimaeus, shout to him and do not allow anyone to silence your voice. Cry out and tell Jesus what you need.
Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on us. We need a touch from you. Touch me. Touch us in our need, which we lift right now in our hearts.
In this time of worship, celebrate God's goodness. In this time of celebration, know that Jesus touched your place of need. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. And give Annie a chance to switch screens and she will start our hymn for us. Feel free to sing along. The words will be on the screen, but keep yourself
shackled by a heavy burden.
You got it.
Leave the load of guilt and shame. Then the hand of Jesus touched me.
Okay, let's hear it now.
Let us pray that God opens our eyes. May God help us to see Jesus as he reaches out to heal our blindness. May God help us to let go of all those things that keep us in darkness. This day, as God's word is proclaimed, let our hearts and souls respond with joy and transform our lives to do God's will. In Jesus' name. Let us pray our unison prayer. Open our eyes, Lord. Help us to see Jesus as he reaches out to heal our blindness. Help us to let go of all those things that keep us in darkness. This day, as your word is proclaimed, let our hearts and souls respond with joy. Transform our lives to do your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God in community, holy and one. Gather us into your heart, even as we pray as we are taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Take heart. Get up. Jesus is calling to us. We trust in the one who has guided the church for two millennia. Through Christ, God forgives us our failings and continues to call us into a community of mutual love and forgiveness. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. So our Hebrew Bible reading is Psalm 34, the first eight, or the verses 1 through 8. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. Magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. Look to him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed. This poor soul cried and was heard by the Lord and was saved from every trouble. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in him.
The Christian Testament reading today is from Mark 10, verses 46 to 52. They came to Jericho. And as he and his disciples and a large crowd were leaving Jericho, Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet, but he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." So throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. And Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go. Your faith has made you well." Immediately, he regained his sight and followed him on his way. May God bless our understanding of his word.
Thank you, Jan. Let us pray. Now may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O God, our strength and our salvation. Amen. So a few months ago, I had the privilege of leading our consultants from Partners in Vision from the UCC Building and Loan Fund on a tour of our neighborhood. They wanted to get a feel for where we are as a building in Salem. They especially wanted to see our proximity to First Church. So I led the group, both our consultants and our leaders of the next steps, down Federal Street to North Street and into the alley that leads to the back door of First Church. where we were met by the chair of their standing committee, who then gave us a tour of their building. Afterwards, we proceeded down the path in front of the church and crossed Essex Street to Hamilton Street, where we went the short block to Chestnut Street. There, across from Hamilton Hall, we entered the neighborhood park, where a plaque commemorates where South Church stood until 1924, when they merged with us as Tabernacle upon the completion of our current building. From there, we processed down Chestnut Street, crossed Summer Street to Crombie Street. We walked down the block and stood across from the building where Crombie Street once worshiped. We explained how Tabernacle supported Crombie Street in their mission to serve meals to the homeless that eventually developed into what is now Lifebridge. I asked folks to look down Crombie Street toward Lyne Street, where lo and behold, you can actually see Tabernacle from that spot. Of course, we pointed out that First Church and Tabernacle both worshiped on the corner of Washington and Essex Streets. Imagine, that means back in the 17 and 1800s, there were five congregational churches all within a few blocks of each other. Now, speaking of walking in the neighborhood, last weekend, Jim and I attended the magic show that's held up in Emerson Hall with one of our friends. Washington Street had been blocked off, as it probably is this morning, and it was incredible to walk in the street, to look up at our steeple that was lit with the Halloween colors, and hear the visitors remark about our rainbow doors and the lighted steeple. What a witness we are in 2024 to the thousands who throng our streets this month. Have you ever walked through your neighborhood with someone who's never been there before? If not, try it sometime. It's amazing what a new person will notice about your street that you just don't pay attention to anymore. Perhaps that's a bit like how the crowd felt when Jesus stopped and responded to Bartimaeus in today's text. Had the crowds gotten so used to Bartimaeus shouting that they neglected to actually pay attention to what he was saying? How many times had he called out for mercy, only to have his neighbors treat him as one more ignorable fixture in their lives? Now, maybe that's not fair, or not entirely fair. Sometimes we choose not to pay attention because we feel helpless to do anything. Noticing would require us to do something. But whether our congregants are more like the crowd or more like Bartimaeus, or perhaps a mixture of the two, there's a good chance they're coming to worship struggling to see and feel seen, hear and be heard, know and feel known. So, how do we help people notice what Jesus notices? When we gather for worship, Jesus pays attention and asks us, "What do you want me to do for you?" May our answer lead us into greater connection and transformative relationships with God, self, neighbor, and creation. They told Bartimaeus to be quiet. They told him to keep up to the margins, to stay away, don't interrupt. But he kept on shouting. Now here's the amazing part. Jesus asked him what he wanted. I know you're thinking, what's so amazing about that? He was shouting for attention. Of course he's going to know what he wanted, but I found that isn't always true. Sometimes the loudest shouters don't really know what they want. They only know they aren't happy or aren't getting their way, or are forced into some change, some position that they don't want. So they may be able to answer Jesus if he asks them, "What don't you want?" or "Why are you unhappy?" But Jesus doesn't tend to ask what's wrong. He asks, "What would make it right? What do you want me to do for you?" Bartimaeus didn't hesitate. "Let me see again. Not solve all my problems or make bad things or bad people go away. Let me see again. Then from there, I'll follow you. From there, I'll let your will become as my will as I daily search out the path that you would have me walk. Yet let me see again, so that I can be about the business of opening eyes to who you are and what you have to offer this world that clings to its blindness. Let me see again, so that I can find you wherever I need to." We've been walking with Jesus through the 10th chapter of Mark, and now we're at the end, watching blind Bartimaeus receive his sight. And we wonder what we've missed along the way. Would we have been among the hushers when the beggar at the gates of Jericho started shouting that day? Or would we have seen him as Jesus saw him, not as a problem to be solved or an issue to be debated, but as a man with the ability to decide and determine and choose for his own life? "Let me see," Bartimaeus declares that sunny day outside the walls of Jericho. Maybe that should be our cry too, our prayer and our hope. Maybe that should be our spiritual discipline this fall. Take a walk around the neighborhood where our church sits. What do you see? What draws your attention? What shouts to you as you pass? Let Jesus open your eyes to the familiar and maybe see it in a whole new way. Walk around our neighborhood with our consultants was to help them answer these kinds of questions as we try to determine what the next 100 years on this site is best for us in terms of our mission. Look at our building. Sure, it's familiar and welcoming to you and yours, but is it accessible to all? Is there an invitation in the art and the color and look and feel of the place? Is there something that speaks not only to our story and our faith, but something that looks familiar to the community around us? Does the face of Jesus that we project resemble us or them or both? It comes down to whether we're among those who are telling the outsider, the stranger, the marginalized, to be quiet and not disturb the status quo, or whether we choose to be those who say, "Take heart, he is calling you. Take heart, this message is for you. This hope is for you, and not just for us. Sure, we have blindnesses that need to be healed as well. Yes, we need to hear the voice of Jesus calling us and asking us what we need. We are a part of those to whom Jesus has come, but we often, knowingly and unknowingly, hoard that message, that voice, that partner with whom we walk as though he were our special possession and not the one who came to the whole world. Like James and John in last week's text, we want to claim places of honor as our right. When walking with Jesus teaches us, is that we aren't the ones guiding the path. We aren't the ones who are determining where to go or what the next steps are. We've surrendered that responsibility when we decided to follow Jesus. Bartimaeus saw that. We could learn from one who was blind, but now sees, because he asked, "Let me see." Let's listen or sing along while muted to the hymn, "Open My Eyes." You have anything to add? Oh, there we go. Okay, I think we're back. So some of you wrote in the notes. It's always a challenge when we're on Zoom only, and it's just Annie and I trying to keep things going. And Annie, you've done a tremendous job of getting it all ready for us this morning and doing all the switching back and forth between your PowerPoint and the screen and the songs. So, and everyone, I want to thank you all for bearing with us. It's great that you all have stayed with us through this challenge, and it's great to be able to see you all and worship with you all. So, I would ask at this point, those of you who would be willing to put on your videos so we can see one another. And we'll at this point wave to each other and say to each other, the peace of Christ be with you and also with you.
Also with you.
Oh,
also with
and Sarah, also put your head down. She had eye surgery this week. She's supposed to keep her head down. So.
Oh, geez.
Okay. So let's now we can work move to our sharing of prayer concerns and celebrations. So as usual, if you have a prayer concern that you'd like to share, please unmute yourself and just go ahead. Together. Why is it that we are afraid to cry aloud our need to God? We sit in our darkness and cry and complain about the dire circumstances that have overtaken us. Yet when given the opportunity to approach the Savior who offers us light and healing, we still cower in the darkness, not daring to believe that healing and light are possible for us. The darkness of our souls invades all of our lives. It colors our attitudes and determines our actions. Lord Jesus, come and shine your light not only on us, but in us and eventually through us. Break the barriers we have erected against peace, freedom, and hope. Bathe us in the light of love, and we shall become bearers of that incredible light for others who dwell in darkness. As we receive the light from you, give us courage and confidence to reach out in compassion and service in your name. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll give Annie the chance to try to put on our closing hymn, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. Be glad in another week when all those ads go away. And now, beloved, go in the blessing of Christ's mercy. May God grant you persistence to cry out for help, an open heart to notice the cries of others, and the courage to listen and lend a loving hand to neighbors, known and unknown. Amen.